Guys, I say this from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much. We hit our first milestone, 100 subscribers. I'm in disbelief. I never thought we would ever hit this number, nor hit this number in such record time, just under 2 months. Look, I know many would scoff at that number and call that a tiny fan base, but like your girlfriend, I don't care about size. I care about the people in it, and I just have to say, I am the luckiest guy ever to have such wonderful people to call us fans. I'll have to create something special for this occasion, but I don't even know where to begin in expressing my gratitude. But how about something simple first? Like a thank you. Thank you to you all, my friends. Before we begin this video, I want to shout out my guy, Chris Nada. He showed me some of his custom creations, and holy fuck, they are incredible. He's planning to make an Insta account dedicated to showing off these masterpieces. So, dude, let me know what it is so I can spread the word when it's made. Another guy I want to give a mention to is this dude on Twitter, PledTrout94. It's a crime against humanity that this dude only has 185 followers. Have you seen this guy's work? He is the Picasso among Picassos, the Hawking of geniuses, the Rachmaninoff's third of music. I don't even know what to say. In the small chance he sees this, Allegato, you inspire me. Link to his Twitter in the description. Okay, well, that's enough gushing and gratitude. Get that sentimental crap out of there. The subject of the video today is our two-wheeled red and white dominatrix, RC. I fucking love her design on ROTB. Even more than her design on Bumblebee, which is so weird considering that I think the designs of everyone else who carried over into this movie were significantly downgraded. That goes especially hard for some. Unfortunately, there aren't many great toys for her. Yes, I know the Weaponizer one exists, but it's so wildly out of scale in both modes. So I settled for the Core class, and you know what? She has really grown on me. But there are a few things that can be tweaked to give this design some justice, and I can't wait to show you my journey in turning this into this. Before we begin, remember to subscribe and like this video if you like the video. Let me know what you guys want to see from me and this channel. Give me a follow too on my Instagram to see teases for future projects and videos. Oh, and I'm live on Twitter too. Want to see some of my shitty opinions? Then hit that follow button there as well. All links will be in the description below.
Oh, this is Core Class Rise of the Beasts RC. She's actually a very fun figure. If you want to see my mini review of it and a small stop motion I did, go check out this video right here. First problem that's easily fixed is the paint job. This is not accurate to the final film version, but that's probably going to be pretty easy to remedy. The second issue I have are these arms. Like, what is with this, like, bicep baggage? It's really weird looking. I don't like it. And although it makes up, like, the end of the car, I mean, sorry, motorcycle mode, I think we can sacrifice a bit of this and still retain a pretty good alt mode nonetheless. So I think I'm gonna cut this part off. And finally, the wheels on her legs. Now, this is accurate to, you know, her. Sorry, let me just transform it really quickly to her, like, Revenge of the Fallen mode, I guess. But no, I really want the wheels on her back because it looks really cool that way. Really love that Energon RC reference, intentional or not. So yeah, those are the three issues we're gonna fix. I'll guide you through how I'm gonna do all three of them. So just like a minute cutting, look at how much of an improvement that is. Like, jeez. This is actually what a slender arm looks like. This is just weird. And RC in Rise of Beasts is supposed to be super athletic, super slender, so yeah, super lean. So we're gonna have to, this actually turned out really well. And as you can see, we still have the seat. So it's not really a big deal in motorbike mode. So there's really no disadvantage to doing this. I don't really understand why Hasbro just didn't do this from the get-go, because really it doesn't affect any mode. Okay, so I partially reassembled her, and just look at that difference, man. Like, these actually look like arms now. Yeah, that looks so much better in my opinion. Oh, finally. It doesn't have that fat hanging off her now. So, the more difficult mod we're gonna do is transplanting these wheels onto her arms, sitting and rotating them to the back. Now you're gonna ask how I'm gonna do this, and the answer is with these babies. Ball joints. Let's do it. So I managed to get the wheels off actually much easier than I thought. Plastic is actually much more really soft, so just cut off the hinge. And yeah, I was unable to punch out the pinch because it's a flat head, so you need heat to take it out, and I don't want to accidentally melt the plastic, so I elected not to do that. And it's fine really, because the legs clean up so much better now. Like, look at that. I could finally turn the thigh swivel, not really thigh swivel, but the ball joints, so like her legs are to the feet are to the side without the legs wheels colliding into each other, so it's a lot better. Now the wheels, my plan is to insert the ball joint like somewhere here. Actually, that's kind of a perfect fit, and just have the other end on a ball so that the wheel can rotate to the back. And just creating for the back wheels that she had on her back. It's not necessarily on her back, it's on the back of her arms, but I think it's close enough and it's an improvement over having wheels on her perpetually on her legs, where it's just like kibble. So yeah, we'll see how this goes. So after maybe 30 minutes of cutting and gluing, and then waiting another 4 hours for it to cure, here we have the motorcycle mode. So basically I modded the wheels to attach to the arms. I'm going to show you how it looks now. Hopefully this goes okay. I didn't fully attach it, because what we're going to do next is we're going to use some epoxy putty to solidify the connection of the ball joints to the wheel, because as you can see, it's kind of hanging on there for dear life. I can still move it around, but it's a bit precarious in my opinion. But okay, let's just transform it really quick. So yeah, this is what she sort of looks like now. To be honest, I do wish her wheels kind of conform more to her back instead of just hanging onto her arms, but this piece is kind of blocking it. I think I'm gonna shave that down so the wheels can move further back. But first we're gonna have to solidify the connection of the ball joints, because I'm a bit worried about them. But I think it's still an improvement over what it was originally. The wheels are gone on her legs, and now she's a lot more slim. And she doesn't have such a big caboose anymore, since the wheels are kind of adding to that bulk. Her caboose. So yeah. I don't know, I think it's an improvement. What do you guys think? So I kind of put on the epoxy putty to solidify the connection of the ball joint to the wheel, as you can see here. We didn't need to cut anything away from the arm. So before it was really sticking out. But that's actually easily remedied if we just rotate this around and place it on her back. Place it back, I mean. And it kind of fixes the problem of the wheel sticking out too far from the body. It's more aligned to her back now, and it does look a lot better. So this is basically RC done in terms of her major modifications to the actual mold. Gaps filled out, and I managed to shave the extraneous putty off so it doesn't look so weird. Now it's more of like a cuboid shape instead of just a mess, and it will further be disguised once we put some black paint on it. I'm not too worried about that. The next step is to paint her up in the proper ROTB color, since that's probably the biggest difference from concept art to the final version. Especially when it comes to the nipple headlights. They shouldn't be there in the final version. I had to work with the epoxy putty to get the neck brace right. It wasn't in there in the sculpt, but it's there on the CGI model, so I guess we're just gonna wait for this to dry. So it's been about 12 to 15 hours and the epoxy putty has dried. Let me show you the feet. I forgot to mention this, but when I was doing the chest sort of lines, I had a little bit of epoxy putty left, so I created new feet for her because the original ones were just stubs. I didn't like that, and she has some glorious Quentin Tarantino worthy feet, so I just created these added remaining epoxy putty I had in the batch that I mixed together. So those are the legs done. And the chest lines look pretty nice. And if you're wondering how I got the white to look right, I actually didn't paint it. I actually removed the paint and I removed the little red lines that went down the sides of her chest, because in the actual movie model, they're more like triangles of red on her chest. So yeah, I'm gonna have to redo that with some masking. First time I'm gonna mask, so that's gonna be fun. And if you're wondering how I managed to remove the white paint, red paint, all I used was these alcohol swabs. Apparently Hasbro paints all their figures with acrylics, so that was easy enough to remove. If I do say so myself, the masking job I did, first time ever doing it, didn't turn out too badly. I had to, as you saw, I had to scrape a little bit with this toothpick, but yeah, that's clean. Definitely going to practice my masking from here on out. So here we have Rise of the Beast RC 90% complete in a robot mode in terms of painting. As you can see, here's the chest. Very happy with how the masking turned out, as I said before. First time masking and it didn't turn out like shit. So that I'm pretty happy with. Very happy with the sort of cross on her chest. She's a true Christian, you know? Too bad she dresses like... Let's not go there. But yeah, very nice. I really like gunmetal. It's amazing. I love this color. I'm so glad I picked it up. I even got an extra spare bottle in case for the time when the first bottle runs out. So always equipped with that color specifically. So nice. Legs done. Very happy with the new feet. Blend in quite well with the existing sculpt. And I'm very happy how I blended the gunmetal and the silver together. just like my BBM Optimus in terms of the ab section. Love that contrast. Arms, not much has been done. Again, I used a gunmetal silver combo. Love it with the no arm. Looks so mechanical. Yeah, gorgeous. Love this. And the arm is just painted in front white, just like they are in the seat, just like they are in Rise of the Beasts. These red sections just need to be similar to how her chest goes, as in the red stripes should be thicker. Thankfully, I still have this from the robot mode, so no wasted tape, and I don't have to measure it out again. I'm so happy I didn't throw this out. Technically, in the movie, this turns into her chest, but that's a massive case of mass shifting, so whatever. So we'll just put this on the front, and we'll basically do the same thing we did in robot mode. I'm gonna get a Q-tip, just... Yeah, so we're done with the front section of the bike now. We're just gonna have to wait for this, these two pieces to dry. And I'll take off the masking tape. But here's the part I've been dreading. Oh god. We're going to have to write Ducati on her right leg. God damn, this is gonna be so difficult. There's a guy on YouTube called Ian Zero. He managed to do this with a really thin brush. And I have one thin-ass brush right here. I'm not sure how good my painting skills are. God damn, this is gonna be so difficult, man. Jesus, I've never done anything like this before, but wish me luck. I was like shaking all over when writing this, but I don't think it's terrible for my first time ever. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. At least it spells Ducati. At least you can tell it says Ducati on there. I guess that's enough. Not too greedy. We'll just wait for this to dry. Wait for the front to dry. Huh. Turned out basically perfect this time. Excellent. So I just had to press down more earlier than I would have gone and finished like this. Interesting. Well, at least we're done with the hard part, masking. Actually, it wasn't as hard as I thought, but then again, I only masked twice, and they were for really tiny pieces. Get rid of that tiny bit of blotch there. Yeah, now... now, it is... perfect with a capital P. Yep. Okay. So, next step, of course, is to top coat this. And as you can see, I actually disassembled the figure this time. I put them on these rods, put blue tack so the claws don't chew up the plastic. And I disassembled it this time because, unlike SS38, this was really easy to disassemble. SS38 was made out of like a billion pins. They were impossible to remove, so I just basically sprayed it as a whole robot and a whole truck. But this time we can do it piece by piece. Once we top coat the robot mode, we'll touch up the vehicle mode, then do a final top coat on the vehicle mode, and we're done basically. 15 hours later, the top coat has finally cured. Yeah, let me just take it off the mount. And we'll see how it turned out. So this is RC in her bike mode. Unfortunately, due to how the arms transform, there's going to be a slight gap in between, but in certain angles, it looks still like a Ducati motorcycle, so I think it's fine. The toes blend in quite well, so that's not a problem for me. Yeah, you just need to update some of the paint. I think there's like a white stripe that goes like this way, so we're gonna have to paint that. We're gonna have to paint this back section white, I believe. But with that, I think our journey is coming to a close. So here is RC in her crotch rocket mode, and yeah, as you can see, I have a little bit of blue tech just to keep it stable. Yeah, I'm very happy how this turned out. Honestly, of course I'm a bit upset there's a tiny gap due to how the mules now transform, but from most angles you really can tell, even from the front, it's mostly, well maybe not from this angle, but it's mostly fine I think. From most angles, it's alright. Like, I'm pretty sure I can get this gap in closer. I've actually done it before, so it shouldn't be too hard to do it again, but yeah, I just want to show you this motorcycle mode. Now, I'm particularly proud of the new skill I learned, which is masking. For my first time ever doing it, I don't think I did that terrible of a job. This white line and this like red sections on the front were done by masking off the figure. As you can see, I have my Tamiya masking tape here. And basically, the lesson I learned in masking is that if you want perfect lines, all you just have to do is get a cotton bud, just gently rub the tape, the edges of the tape that you're applying, so that no paint can bleed under the tape and ruin the lines. But even if you ruin the lines, you can just get a toothpick and basically chip away the paint, the excess paint that you don't want, which is what I did for the robot mode, which was actually my first ever time doing it. This is like my second, it's like my third, so as you can see, it just got progressively better. Was this my second or was this my, I think this is my second, this was my third time doing it. Yeah, so I'm really happy with how the motorcycle mode turned out. I just had to paint this section white, just like a real vehicle. It was originally red, not too big of a deal. Honestly, I don't understand why Hasbro decided made the biceps so fat, when like you barely can tell there's like a gap between this section and that section. I mean, even if we kept the sections here, the biceps are still obviously there. So, I mean, even if it's like a curvaceous like end, it wouldn't be like completely curvaceous because of these ball joints that are exposed here. So, I mean, I don't really understand the logic behind that. So yeah, I think that's enough talking in regard to the vehicle mode. Let's get her to her robot mode. And here we have the robot mode, and I'm just so proud of how this turned out. Like with my other mods, like the really extensive ones like my SS38 and Kibling, I had to follow like guides in order to do it. But for this particular figure, I figured out how to replace her wheels all by myself. I wasn't really checking other customizers on whether they've done something like this. I just took the leap of faith, as Peter B. Parker would say, and just went for it. I'm very happy how this turned out. Obviously, the wheels aren't on her back, but are on the back of her arms. But I think it still gives that illusion that the wheels are coming from her back. So, yeah. And anyway, it's a lot better than having the wheels just on her legs. And as you can see, just by taking off the wheels, like, look at how much that cleans the proportions up. Like, she actually looks like ROTB RC. One thing that I really started to appreciate about this figure when I started customizing her was the amount of detail on her. I mean, the abdomen section is just full of movie-accurate goodness. Like, look at that, that's amazing. It's a combination of gunmetal and chrome silver. It really just brings it all out as mechanical detail. And I'm particularly proud of her face. Sorry for the lighting, but it's a bit dark. But yeah, I used white, pink, and baby blue for eyes, gunmetal on the top of her helmet, a bit of Pantone accent color for the grays to Pantone her helmet. Yeah, it just turned out awesome. And for The other mods that I've done, I used putty to fill out the hollow spots that were originally on her biceps and on her thighs. I recessed it a bit because I really like this like sort of like jagged detail, but I still filled it out because, you know, I don't like hollow bits. And her feet, they look like feet now instead of just nubs. I'm very happy with that. I wasn't planning to make feet, but yeah, I'm very happy with it. And Quentin Tarantino would be like ecstatic over these feet. Yeah, and I made a neck brace out of the epoxy putty as well. You know, I've started to really get a hang of epoxy putty now. And yeah, I can't wait to show you my next custom, which I've actually used epoxy putty for as well. And just, you know what? Take a gander in the comments below on what my next custom is gonna be. Yeah, so I'm very happy with her. And I'm very happy with the masking job I've done on her chest as well. This. Basically, I kind of fucked up a bit, but really it was no big deal. Because I didn't know about using the Q-tip to rub it on, press it down firmly onto the chest. So a little bit of paint like bled through the through under the tape. I used a toothpick and remove the excess like I talked about in the vehicle mode. And now it's perfect, so yeah, not a big deal. Another skill I learned in this customizing journey was using a hand drill. Where the hand drill came in handy was customizing the gun. As you can see, there are two holes now in the gun when in the barrels. Before, it was just a solid piece. I think it looks a lot better now. And when I was customizing a gun, I was just like, I had no idea how to use it, so I was just like inserting and pressing it as hard as I can and just doing half turns, just like doing it like this, and it just took forever. But I soon figured it out because that this piece spun. You just have to press it against your palm and you turn it this way. And just like it automatically does the job for you. I don't know why I was being such a dumbass with this, but yeah, it's actually pretty simple to use. I think this will be very handy whenever I need to insert pins or whatever in the future, so yeah. What else? Yeah, you probably want to see her with the rest of my R2B customs that I got here. So here is Big Man Prime. This is exactly why I decided to opt for the core class, because if I got the weaponizer, it would just be wildly out of scale. I think this is actually a really good scale for RC. I've seen people talk about how small she is, but I think this is accurate. If I remember correctly, RC in Rise of the Beast is 8 fucking feet tall. I'm pretty sure, okay, this might be rare, but I'm sure there are humans taller than RC. Like, that's fucking insane, man. Fucking insane. And then here is R2B Transit, Mr. Busboy himself. One thing I didn't talk about in my transit video was that, yeah, he should be like here, but whatever, it's fine. He's still pretty big and bulky, just like he is in the deleted scene, so that's fine. You know, here we have the R2B family. I wonder, I wonder who else is going to join this little sub-faction of mine in the future, but yeah, my 3 ROTB customs, very happy with how they turned out. I hope you like how they look. Oh, one little note before we end this video is the gun, right? So I actually painted this in a silver, but not a chrome silver that I usually do. I actually tried a new paint called aluminum silver from Tamiya. And you know what? It's actually a really different sheen from the chrome silver. They're both silver, but I didn't know you could just have such a vast range of silvers. What am I even saying? But yeah, this is, I don't know. I think this will be a very useful pigment, a silver that, you know, can come in handy if I want to ever have a duller finish, but the piece still needs to be silver. Saying silver a lot. Take a shot every time I say silver. So, yeah, very happy how this crew has, you know, Cole has come together. come together right now. Oh, for me. Yeah. So, yeah, very happy with all three of them. I learned a lot. And as you saw in my montage, another skill that I learned was actually properly placing the characters in the movie stills. Before, I didn't even bother removing the actual character from the background, so you can just see the outlines and pieces of the original CGI model, but I figured out how to remove the character entirely and place the figure slash character into the movie still. Let me know if you want a tutorial on it. It's completely free, though it's a bit of a it's a bit of a hassle. But let me know if you want a tutorial on that, and I will gladly do so. And that's it for now. I hope you have a great rest of the day. Thank you for the 100 subscribers. I'll do something special for that. And you know what? Just thank you for the time you've graciously given to me.